I need your help with Lennox air conditioner troubleshooting.
For Lennox split ACs, the EO error is the EEPROM parameter error. E1 is the error for communication between the indoor and outdoor errors, while E5 is for a short circuit or open circuit in either the outdoor unit or outdoor temperature sensor.
I'm not seeing an error with an E in it.
Some error messages are the same between the various Lennox ACs, such as P1 being for overvoltage and too low voltage.
All it means is that there's some type of power supply problem, either too much or too little. That's rather generic.
P1 means it either had a surge and shutdown or too little power during a brownout and shutdown. If you did not have a thunderstorm or power outage, you can try to turn on the unit after it has been shut down for a few minutes.
It would take me that long to find the circuit breaker.
You can get the P1 error if a fuse went out or breaker flipped too. You may need to go and manually hit the control panel to turn it on or turn it off at the thermostat and try to bring it on.
And if it does not come back on?
There's a bigger electrical problem than someone running too many appliances at once and more local than the power grid, and you probably want to turn it off and call tech support.
You mean an HVAC guy?
Sure, though you could try turning it off, waiting 5 minutes, and powering it back up. That resets the control panel, kind of like rebooting a computer.
The downside of smart homes, unfortunately, many of their error notices are as inscrutable as a screen full of text during a blue screen of death.
If all the outside LEDs are off, the unit has terminated due to a communication error. If all lights are on and not blinking, everything is normal.
What if it is blinking?
All off but the yellow one means there's an EEPROM failure, so replace the control panel. The yellow light blinking is a communication failure, but it might be fixed by replacing wires or resetting the control panel.
If in doubt, reboot is advice I expect for a PC, not an AC.
The low pressure errors and discharge line sensor kick in if you have a bad refrigerant leak. Though that's more obvious if there's ice buildup on the coil, sizzling sounds as it defrosts, or really bad moisture buildup.
Of course, if the unit floods due to extra water buildup, that can cause electrical problems too.
At least that is obvious when you open it up to look at it and the water flows out.